chase this speech because it's a talk about people should not try to find some other planet like Mars as a backup place for living when we mess up the Earth. Instead, we should preserve and appreciate what we have right now. And why I chose this TED Talk, because I think the topics is very interesting. I especially like when the speaker talks about the more you look for planets like Earth, the more you appreciate your own planet. I think this sentence is very interesting because nowadays a lot of people, they are just obsessed with finding new place, new planet for to support human lives. I don't mean this is wrong, but people just forget how beautiful and precious our planet is. And some companies even consider to provide some private planet trip for, to the outer space, or even living in outer space, and use this as a trigger for their new business and to earn more money. And I think this is terrible because, not because the trip may be interesting, but they will use tons of resources and energies on Earth, and this will damage the Earth even more. And so I think this TED Talk is a good reminder for us to just rethink these issues deeply. And
New York, 8 million beautiful, diverse people. It's why we can get the best dumplings, tamales, and gnocchi.
So I think if you go back and forth between PowerPoint, and just keep it not full screen if you're going back and forth between PowerPoint and YouTube, I just need to fix the display.
But the goals of interplanetary exploration and planetary preservation are not opposed to one another. No, they're in fact two sides of the same goal: to understand, preserve, and improve life into the future. The extreme environments of our own world are alien vistas. They're just closer to home. If we can understand how to create and maintain habitable spaces out of hostile, inhospitable spaces here on Earth, perhaps we can meet the needs of both preserving our own environment and moving beyond it.
And this is the part I choose. And this is the transcript.
And you could go back to full screen now, I think. If you can.
Of interplanetary exploration and the planetary preservation are not opposed to one another. No, they're in fact two sides of the same goal: to understand, preserve, and improve life into the future. The extreme environments of our own world are alien vistas. They're just closer to home. If we can understand how to create and maintain the habitable spaces out of a hostile, inhospitable spaces here on Earth, perhaps we can meet the needs of both preserving our own environment and moving beyond it. And as you can see, the transfer, I focus on four points, which is linking flat T, the pronounced E, and the intonations. And the speaker's voice is very neutral, but I think, as you can see, the intonation mark I drew here she talks very, is full of emotions. And as you can see the linkings, I found when there's a letters is vowel and the letter is consonant, they will always link together. And interesting is that when the word is ended by T and started, and the other word is started by T, the first word is T is reduced. And the also the in this part of the talk there's a lot of flat T like interplanetary and the crate and habitable and like out of like inhospitable. Those are the things I found that is really makes the speech fluently and allow me to imitate that. And from this project, I think I learned a lot. I could, it's very helpful for me to practice the listening and speaking. For the speaking part, I think I have done some imitation practice before, but it is always me in a general way. I just imitate their feelings when they talk and not those specific details. And in this practice, I focus more on those details. And I found this is really helpful for me to really imitate the way they talk and understand why they're talking this way. And because I need to listen again and again to try to catch every details and imitate that, it's also helped me to practice my listening skills. And now I could distinguish those, it's called liaison of the words. Liaison of the words. And help me to be quicker and easier to understand the content. And besides that, I also learned some interesting words, and I want to share with you. The first one is vista. It's a pleasant view, especially when seen through the long, narrow opening. And I also found some pictures that could visualize these words and help us to understand. This is a vistas of our own planet. And the second one is hostile. Hostile is the situations and conditions make it difficult for you to achieve something. For example, a hostile climate. This is a picture. for this little poor polar bear, I think this environment is a typical hostile climate.
It's more hostile now.
Yeah,
too.
Yeah. It's global warming. And the last one is inhospitable. It's often described an environment which is harsh and difficult to live in, like the Mars. We couldn't find some waters and airs or some essential elements for people to use when we in Mars. So so that's why we really should appreciate the our own planet and to try to find ways to preserve it, and that's all.